We are presenting our topic is breast cancer, and we are going to discuss about what breast cancer is actually and how to overcome that, and we will build an app for that so that the cure for breast cancer be a bit simpler. So we know that, like all forms of cancer, breast cancer is made of unusual cells that grow out of control. Breast cancer usually begins either in your glands or the ducts that carry to the ductarial carcinoma. And breast cancer happens both in men and women, but it is majorly seen in women. So this is a small brief about breast cancer, and we will be developing an app where we will it in a way that we will go to the doctors for and will help them in a way that they won't have to. Our app will be built in a way that they can detect the breast cancer, and can for people at home can detect breast cancer, so that the doctors can proceed with further operations. So this is something I just give much to say.
Thank you, Ashmita. I just little bit add to this presentation by Ashmita. We are not claiming any way that we will cure breast cancer, or we will within 2-3 months we will come up with a tool that will aid to detect the breast cancer. What is basically we want, actually 3 years back we have started with our brain tumor diagnosis software, and then we have also CT scan, lungs cancer diagnosis software, and we have partly developed and fully developed these. We have own prizes. Basically, it is kind of awareness driving. Whenever you are developing product or a program from the scratches, you are aware of your what are the medical diagnosis system and all these things, what is false positive, false negative on accuracy and all these things. So we can come to know all these things in this process. So we are doing this is the history, because we have already done brain tumor project, lungs cancer, detection, lungs, any anomaly detection. So that is the thing we have started. We congratulate the team for taking this challenging topic, because breast cancer I have tried for the last 2-3 years, but generally the girls are a bit hesitant and they generally do not want to do the project on this. So I am really thankful to Ashmita, Devadrita particularly, and Devajyoti also, and Arpita, because they are working as a team, for because we have to get rid of this shameless. We have to talk explicitly of all these issues, because breast cancer is on the topmost cancer causing in women, and also men also attacked by breast cancer. That is very fatal. And problem of breast cancer is generally the ladies high rate, and at least detected in third and fourth stages. And you know the cancer in every cancer, even brain tumor also, in the first stage 1 and stage 2, they are high, not at all detectable at all. And we generally do not do the, Indians generally do not do the yearly any medical checkup. So that is the reason we are trying to develop the softwares and all this for early detection. Thank you, Ashmita. Now, Devajyoti, please, you can talk.
Okay. So, hello, everyone. Okay, so we are going to work on breast cancer detection basically. So and for that we need some kind of images already that are being captured, like histopathology images or ultrasound images. So I just searched a lot about what type of images are available in open source. So the best I can find is that the histopathology images, which is about 3 GB in total. There are a lot of like 10,000 or more images in it. We'll be like classifying them as malignant or non-malignant breast cancer. So and after that we'll be implementing that in a web app, so that our histopathology image can be input and can be given as an input, and output shows that how much percent it assures that it is a malignant or non-malignant. So basically it is a classification problem. So still I am searching for a better image database, but till now I am fine. I'll be starting my work as in the histopathology images. Okay, so this image basically basically like there are a lot of patients, and for each patient like it may be like malignant or non-malignant. It is given here. Zero means non-malignant and one means malignant here. Okay, so I have already archived, I have already downloaded that, and let me show you. Okay, so I have just extracted that zip. So let me open one. So the images that are taken are then divided into 50 by 50 multiple images. So all the images of a patient are divided into several images of 50 by 50. That is, this processing already done in the database.
Just a minute, so, Ashmita, can you mute yourself? Ashmita, mute yourself. Thank you.
Okay. So all the images are then cropped 50 by 50 into multiple images. Like this image is very small, so and we have to work on these images only. So like I am giving explanation about my basic method. Like what we'll be doing is we'll first read all the images, and after that the images are already been transformed to a particular 50x50. I have already checked that all the images are 50x50, so we do not need any transformation. But after that, yes, we need to just these all are RGB images, so we have to convert them to grayscale format or something else. So yes, I am talking about the traditional way at first, and we'll be working on deep learning approach later part of this project. So first of all, we are trying on the traditional machine learning approach. So all the images we'll convert them to grayscale, and after that we'll be implementing some classification algorithms, and then we'll be classifying, and this is how the work will be done. So the input will be like and after that we'll implement in a web app, we are thinking. So the input will be like a person will upload histopathology images, and after that the image will be divided into 8 parts again, maybe 8 or 9 parts according to the size of that image, because basically that will be of 50x50 image portion I am talking about. And after that that will be tested against our model, and the result will get evaluated. Okay, so this is what I have explained the traditional way how it is done. And after after completing that, we will be observing the result, like how it is performing against different classification algorithms. We'll try every algorithms that are available, and after that we'll implement the deep learning approach. Okay, sir.
Thank you. I remember the Praveen also, whenever started the brain tumor, they has also started the traditional machine learning, then the deep learning. So and not the Android app. It will be web app first, and then Android app. So we are focusing. We are right now focusing on basically the abdomen area. Because Praveen can guide the regarding brain tumor, but what my question is to Debojyoti, how many types of classification? I mean, 0 or 1, or you make some detection of stage 1, stage 2, stage 3?
No, sir. I have not found any database that are claiming defined types. It's just malignant or non-malignant.
No, the 0, 1, binary classification.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir, I would like to.
Debojyoti.
In one Devadita, website,
make your camera on right now. Everybody can make their camera on, please, if possible. Praveen has some issues. Yeah, Praveen.
Sir, actually, in one website,
Ashmita, make your camera on. Devojyoti, also make you coming on. Orpita, you can. Yeah.
Sir, in one website, I had found that some data set where, like, already the data set was made.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we don't have to classify. So,
okay.
On based on that data set, sir, I have done. Sir, should I share my screen? Like,
yeah, okay. Definitely, you can share. Please share.
Okay, sir.
Very good thing. Ashwita, what about your camera? Ashwita Kumari.
Is it necessary to...
No, that's okay. Not at all. Not at all. Next day. It is a formal, no? This is either part of a course curricula. We are not this thing. We are not partying. Okay. Yeah,
sir, in this one, sir, actually I had got these things, so I just in Jupyter, sir, I just had run these.
Yeah.
And since these data sets were already available,
okay,
from before, from there only, from the CSV file I had taken.
Okay.
So here, see, it is showing whether it is malignant or benign.
Yeah.
In this part.
Great.
So, sir, based on that,
yeah,
sir, it is like it is converted to binary.
Okay.
And then here, sir, it is showing that it is 91% accurate.
Okay.
I had just seen
actually, no, that's okay. But this is a known data. That means already you have done.
Yes,
now,
sir.
You have to recalibrate it with the unknown data set. That
okay,
other
sir.
Place. So, it is whatever we have found for
yes,
traditional machine learning, your data's generally... You need maybe 1,000 PhDs do, but whenever you have a deep learning, we need more, maybe 10,000 and 20,000. And generally, these data should be anonymous because the breast cancer patient name and all these things cannot be, should not be given here. So, anonymous data is very difficult to get in India, and we should also try to publish our whatever our findings. Generally, whenever you go to any publications, they generally do not highlight whether you have done a web app or Android app. They try to make it that what are the traditional algorithms, the known data set are available. I think Devojyoti has tried free data, and also Devadita, you try to get where the not only reliable data, like Stanford Machine Learning Laboratory, generally that is reliable. That Praveen has already tried with brain tumor, we have done lung cancer. So, you try to find which is Harvard Medical or like this, traditional machine learning. So, even the data might be little less, but that is a dependent. So, that whenever you try your new algorithm, we can say that our algorithm scores this, and then we try to make a web app. Android app come later. So, I now request Praveen to speak some light. Praveen and Titi.
Sir,
before
that, I have a question.
Okay,
Okay, so we are also thinking about the web app and Android app.
Yeah.
So we need images, not the already extracted data.
Okay.
That's
no, images are available. Images are already available only that place. In India, nobody will share you the breast cancer data. That is a very touchy point. So, but other issues like advanced countries like UK, USA, they are already available. That you try to find it out, the actual images. And
in image,
data.
I did not do anything.
Yeah,
I only extracted the data, whatever was available.
But image data must be there. I now, Praveen, can you speak something on it?
First, I have some questions. Can you just
Devadita, can you mute
let
yourself?
Me know what is the use case? Who is the target audience for this? Whether the doctors are.
Who
are going to use
it? It's a general doctor, general P, because we did not go to directly to patients, because then it will create a humongous. So it will be generally from the very general doctors, or maybe diploma doctors, and later definitely the would be advanced patient, maybe that will be highly aware. That is my idea. If anybody can. So, light on it,
Yes, sir. I want to add a line. Like anyone having histopathologic images, image of breast, can upload and test their data.
Okay, good. Then it is where it is available, this application?
No, I am we'll be developing this application.
Yeah, but the thing is that whenever you are making upload, you want to get the data. Who will say that we'll not that we take the image? We definitely you know. Lot of cases we get the data, then we generally might issue the patient. There are a lot of security issues. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir. We can assert that every images that are getting uploaded will be must be deleted within 30 minutes or 15
minutes.
Yeah, but
I think the Devajyoti, first we'll do we do not try to much a stall claim, because you do not know with a good heart we are doing. But the vested, you know the case of famous gynecologist who a doctor ki mouth and all these things, who tried the first is to BB in India. Lots of issues are there. So first we do the what are the algorithms and try to better the algorithms over the our collab platform. Then I think Praveen can say some light on it.
Yeah, have you guys started any algorithms or such?
No, I was just experimenting with basic KNN algorithm, like classification algorithm.
Okay, I suggest you go since the images are divided. I suggest you go for neural network. That will be helpful, and KNN won't do much here.
Yeah, I think Praveen has started. Praveen has issued the random forest also at certain point of time, and you can go to the neural network. Praveen, that model, famous model with 2012. What is his name? Neural network. That model you have used with started okay. With name K, Russian scientist. That's neural network. That is the competition comes out in the that is convolutional network. Convolutional, I think it's a fit case for convolutional network. I think Praveen, that model you have tried.
Yeah.
Okay, that can be done.
It yeah, ResNet. ResNet you are talking about?
No, ResNet. Another scientist, that is a 2012 ConvNet, basically convolutional network. You know there is image processing the convolutional network and recurrent neural network for the data, audio data. So this is a fit case for convolutional network. But there are some traditional neural network is available with, I think, some Yaski or Liaski, certain name in 2012-14. These are the famous deep neural network. But traditional network, that will not get help. But if you want to know machine learning, you have to know a little bit of traditional learning, classification and clustering. Then you can go to the deep learning. In fact, that is easier. And there we all follow the our Facebook's that one. What is it? Torch. Will you follow the torch? PyTorch. So Praveen's programs are there. So great. So I think Devadita,